F1 2017, Michael, you've been playing it. What do you make of it so far?
I've had about an hour and a half of playtime. Certain things I was allowed to do, certain things I wasn't. And I'm quite excited, actually.
What's new this year, then? It does look pretty good. I do love a bit of F1. I know you do as well.
Yeah, I mean, there are five big changes to last year, F1 2016, which I absolutely loved. And obviously the first one is that we've got the new cars for this year, the F1 2017 cars, new regulations. They look different, they look faster, and they drive different as well.
Do you think they look better this year?
I do, I really do.
Yeah, I do as well, actually. A lot of people don't like them, though.
No, those people don't know what they're talking about. No. They look squatter, they look more like race cars, and they look like they are harder to drive.
Are they harder to drive?
In the game, I would say they're more predictable to drive, but if you get it wrong, you're probably going in the wall.
Is that based on your experience as an F1 driver yourself?
Absolutely, yes. As Lewis Hamilton, I can say that with a certain degree of accuracy.
So compared to last year, driving mechanics, how do they feel?
Yeah, I think that at high speed, the cars have way more grip, and at mid-speed, they also have a lot more grip just because they have lots more downforce in real life. And if you get into a slide at a low-speed corner, you have a chance of recovering. It feels very satisfying to drive. I've driven it both with a wheel and with a PS4 controller, and they're both super fun. And I think if you get your driving age just right, there's something for everybody here.
So where does this fall in terms of like arcade versus proper realism?
It's always going to be slightly towards the arcade end of the spectrum, but I think with the wheel and all your driving aids turned off, it is challenging. Whether or not it's 100% realistic is going to be down to whether you know how to drive an F1 car or not.
Which you do, presumably.
Well, yeah, as Lewis Hamilton, I do.
So you've got the new 2017 cars. We also have some classic cars in this, is that right?
Yeah, and they've not done this in several years, and it looks like one of the better implementations of old F1 cars. Yeah, we've got loads of cars from the 80s all the way up to the late 2000s, but the mid-90s and 80s cars, they move around a lot, they have really long brake pedals, so you don't know when you're gonna really need to brake, and they feel really risky to drive, and I think with a wheel, those cars are gonna be amazing. And I think that the community, especially online, really, especially the hardcore racers, will gravitate towards those older cars. And they look great as well.
So let's talk about the visuals and the audio, because this is a stunning looking game, especially with the weather effects. What do you make of it?
I only got to play it on PS4, so regular PS4 on a full HD TV. Normally I play it on PC at a higher resolution, so it's a little bit hard for me to tell. It looks at least as good as the previous game, which is obviously no surprise.
As you'd hope, yeah.
Yes. I didn't get to play in any adverse weather conditions, so that was something actually that I thought needed improving in the previous game, so I hope they've improved that. Lighting is very good, and I think also there's going to be lots of different day and night modes to choose from on various tracks, so I think that's why it looks better this time.
But is there a night and day difference from last year?
Probably not.
Okay. That was a good pun. That was a good pun there, right?
Carry on.
Any optimizations for PS4 Pro?
I believe the next gen 4K consoles will be running at 4K 60fps. This is what I was told at E3 anyway. I've not seen evidence of that, of course, because I've not played on those consoles. However, it does sound like that they are at least very close to getting that nailed.
That'd be really cool.
Yes, it would be. I think that would be a real game changer for console players.
Anyway, thanks for coming by on such short notice. I just needed to cover a couple of quick things with you before you race.
So the career mode has always been a popular part of the F1 series. What's new this year?
Quite a lot, actually. It's a lot deeper than previous years, and I think it was actually really needed. I think your biggest change is there is a huge, not even upgrade tree anymore. It's like an upgrade web of stuff right. You can change on your car by earning when you earn points through making good decisions and making good decisions for.
Driving well?
Yeah, driving well, that's the one. Being a good driver.
So there's some certain RPG elements to this?
It is really a huge RPG style element. You're able to upgrade different aspects of the car, so you can look at your powertrain, your aerodynamics, durability of parts, and the chassis. And each of those four key areas are things you can improve. There are small upgrades you can make, like making your car lighter, or big upgrades you can make, making it significantly lighter.
That sounds really cool. So can you upgrade it badly? Is it like a one choice that makes sense? Or do you have a bit of flexibility in how you upgrade?
I think it's based on the team that you've chosen and luck. If you develop a new front wing and it turns out to be rubbish, you'll know, and you won't be able to, like, basically that entire upgrade has been wasted.
All right.
So you'll have to start from scratch. So in addition to the spider web of upgrades, you also have to manage individual components on your engine. For example, the internal combustion part of it, the kinetic recovery unit, the heat recovery unit, the energy store, so the battery and the turbo and electronics and the gearbox are all items that you only have a limited number you can use throughout the season. This is the same in real life Formula One. And as the season wears on, they wear out. So you can replace them, and then swap back between them, but you can only ever use up to 4 of each. One more thing about career mode, also those lovely practice games that I loved last year, they've added some more. There's now a fuel saving mode, which is really hard and I am unable to do properly. You have to use a small amount of fuel while also setting a fast lap time, which is so hard. I don't think I'll ever do a race in F1 2017. I'll just be doing that challenge repeatedly. And there's also a sort of overall race time mode as well that you have to balance your fuel, your tyres and your lap times to work out a nice strategy for you. So yeah, lots more stuff to do in the career mode.
So what about the championship mode? What's all that about?
So these are really cool, I think. They are, aside from the regular career mode, they're sort of mini championship seasons based around a certain theme or regulation. So for example, you can have a championship where there are 6 events, and at each event there are 2 races. There's a sprint race and then a feature race with reverse grids, which is kind of like F1 fans' kind of fantasy, right? Like, it would be interesting to see what would happen in F1 if there were 2 races per weekend. So I think that's really cool. And there's also other themed ones, so there can be one with like random grids with random weather, the classic car championships as well, you can do those. And also there are a separate set of classic invitational events, which are like overtake as many cars as possible, set a fast lap time, that kind of thing as well. So there's loads of stuff, non-career stuff, you can do. And we've not even got to multiplayer yet, because I've not seen it. There's nothing on multiplayer.
But there is multiplayer.
There will be multiplayer, right. Yes. Very popular, as always.
With a full grid of online people, cars?
Yes, and you'll be able to race classic cars as well, and they'll be divided up into different classes, so you won't be up against cars that you'll never be able to beat.
So sum up your first impressions of the preview build that you've seen of F1 2017. Are you excited for it?
I am excited for it. I think F1 2017 is much more about the off-track enhancements. So the additional career stuff, the engine and car management, and the different game modes really makes the game have a lot more replay value. Instead of just doing career over and over again, you can just, you know, duck out and do some other fun offline single-player stuff and basically spend more time in the menus, but actually feeling like you're doing something useful.
Well, that sounds fun.
Yeah, I know. I think I've not really sold it, but honestly, I think it's going to be hopefully not overcomplicated for those who just want to get in and race, which I think might be the one concern that people have. For me, it's just about perfect.
It does look good. I can't wait to play more. When's it out? What platforms is it on?
August 25th, and it will be on all of the consoles, being the Xbox One, One S, One X, PlayStation 4, PlayStation 4 Pro, PlayStation 8, PlayStation,
Nintendo
personal
DS.
Computer, DS, 3DS.
Sega Mega Drive.
No, not the Mega Drive. Not there's the a Mega Liberty issue on that one, actually. And obviously the PC, which is where everyone should be playing.
That's true. So is that your platform of choice?
Always.
Well, I think that's the checkered flag for this video.
And I'll see you on the podium.
Yes.
Yes.